Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we're going to build a wireless weather station project using Arduino. Without any further delay, let's get started. Today's project is this, a wireless weather station with a big 3.2-inch color TFT display. As you can see, the project is up and running and it displays the current date and time, the indoor temperature and humidity, and the outdoor temperature and humidity. The readings of the outdoor sensor are updated every second in order to demonstrate that we have a reliable communication link established with the transmitter, which is outside at a distance of 5 meters. The readings of the indoor sensor are updated once every minute. The heart of the project is the first Arduino Due, and as you can see, there is no flickering of the screen when the values are updated. Let's now see the transmitter. The transmitter is much simpler. It consists of an Arduino Nano, a DHT22 sensor, and the NRF24L01 wireless transceiver module. The transmitter reads the temperature and the humidity every second and sends them to the receiver via the NRF24L01 module. This is a one-way communication link. We don't know if the receiver actually receives the data, but we send new data every second, so in case we miss a package, we are going to receive another one soon. Let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed for this project are these: an Arduino Due or a Mega, an Arduino Nano, a 3.2-inch color TFT display, two DHT22 sensors, a DS3231 real-time clock module, two NRF24L01 wireless transceiver modules, two breadboards, some header pins, and some wires. The cost of the project is around $40. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. You can lower the cost of the project by $5 if you use the Arduino Mega instead of the Arduino Due. I haven't tested it, but it should work fine as well, but it will be much slower. Let's now connect all the parts together. Before we start, I highly recommend you to watch a couple of videos before attempting to build this project. That's a difficult project for beginners, there are many things that can go wrong, so it requires some experience. That's the reason I encourage you to build the project shown in these videos first. Just click on the card here to watch them. Let's first build the transmitter. It is very simple. We connect the output pin of the sensor to digital pin 4 of the Arduino Nano. We connect the ground and VCC and we are ready. All we have to do now is to connect the NRF24L01 wireless module. Please watch the NRF24L01 tutorial I have prepared in order to see how to connect it. The receiver part is a bit trickier. We have to use 7 header pins and bend them like this. Then we have to place them at the following pins. We need one to ground and one to 3.3 volts. We need two at the I2C pins. We need the remaining three to digital pins from 6 to 8. We also have to solder three wires to the hardware SPI pins of the Arduino Due pins. We need MOSI, MISO and SCK. Check the diagram carefully. We can't use female wires since the display won't fit with the wires attached. We connect the wires to the header pins and we are ready to attach the display. We connect ground and 3.3 volts to the breadboard. Next, we connect the ground and VCC of the DHT22 module and the DS3231 module to the breadboard ground rail and VCC rail. Next, we connect the I2C pins of the real-time clock to I2C wires and the output pin of the DHT22 sensor to digital pin 8. That's it. All we have to do now is to connect the NRF24L01 module. The first pin is ground, so it goes to the breadboard ground. The next pin is VCC, so it goes to the breadboard VCC. Be careful though, the module will be destroyed if you connect it to 5 volts, so be sure that you are providing 3.3 volts to the breadboard rail. The next pin goes to digital pin 6, the fourth pin goes to digital pin 7, the fifth pin goes to hardware SCK pin that we have soldered earlier, the sixth pin goes to MOSI and the seventh to MISO. The last pin stays unconnected. That's it, we are now ready to power up both the transmitter and the receiver. If everything went well, we are going to see live data on the display. Cool! Everything works fine. It wasn't that difficult, was it? Let's now see the code of the project. The transmitter code is very simple. It is almost identical with the code of the NRF24L01 tutorial. The only thing that it has changed is that we now send real data that we get from the DHT22 sensor. Please be sure to use the correct library for the NRF24L01 module. You can find a link for it in the description of the video. Let's now see the receiver code. We need 4 libraries. I now use a different library for the display, which works great. You can download it from a link that can be found in the description of the video. After downloading the library, you have to open the usersetup.h file, comment line 13 and uncomment line 14, because the display we have is using the HX8357C driver. Now we can continue with the 3 other libraries. We need 1 library for the real-time clock, 1 for the DHT22 sensor, and lastly 1 for the wireless module. Let's see the code now. The first thing we have to do is to set the time to the real-time clock module if it is not already set. In order to do it, enter the current date and time in this line of code, uncomment this line of code here, and upload the program to Arduino. Now the time is set. But then we have to comment this line of code again and upload the program to Arduino once more. The code of the receiver works like this. In the setup function, we initialize all the sensors and the modules and we print the user interface. Then, at the loop function, we continuously check for new wireless data. If there is new data, we save that data in variables and print them on the display. We read the temperature and the humidity once a minute, and we only update the display if there is a change in the values. This way, we reduce the flickering of the display even more. I have also prepared a version of the code with the temperature displayed in degrees Fahrenheit. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, this project is a great demonstration of what open source hardware and software is capable of. Within a few hours, one can build such an impressive project. Of course, this is just the beginning. We can add many more features to this project. I will soon add a button so we can display graphs and have different modes. We can also add more sensors, data logging, internet connection, and so on. We are using the Arduino Due, so we have plenty of memory to implement many more things. I would love to hear your opinion on this project. How do you want to see it evolve? Please post your comments or ideas in the comment section below. Thank you! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.